Great! Let the Lord lead you to where he would have you to be, because he's got a special place and purpose in mind for you. Amen?
Amen.
Let us tell this dear sister, welcome.
Welcome.
Amen. And right now, Revelation, let us go and welcome our guests. And only a wish Revelation can do. Amen?
Amen.
Come on.
Yeah.
That means that we are one. When we dwell in unity, it means that we've got some concentrated power. When we dwell in unity, touching and agreeing, how many know the Lord will show up in the midst? Listen, y'all. The worship experience is turning serious right now. It's an opportunity to lay your requests, your burdens, your most inner thoughts, those unanswerable questions. That part that you can't see, that you want to see. We got to turn it over to Jesus. We got to turn it over to Jesus. He says, cast your cares on me. Because I care for you. So right now, you believe that the Lord is in the midst and that he is an answerer and rewarder of them who diligently seek him. Right now is the time to come to the altar and pray. Right now. You see, Hezekiah knew about it. One day he found himself surrounded by 195,000 enemies. The Assyrians had wrote a nasty letter and told Hezekiah, you ought to curse your God and die. But Hezekiah laid the letter before the Lord at the altar. And he says, Lord, look at what the enemy is saying. Well, he had to go to bed on that thing. And he woke up on that thing, too. But when he woke up, there was still 195,000 surrounding him. Only difference was they were dead. God will take care of your enemy in the midnight hour before you wake up.
Our way, Father, that you guide our way, Father. You said you'd be
light unto our pathway, Father. Father, guide us and lead us in your way, Father. Not our will be done, Father, but your will be done. And Father, when it's all said and done down here, Father, we ask that you prepare a place for us, Father. That there we might worship you day and night, Father. Father, we ask, oh God, that you touch us here, Father, touch our youth. Put your loving arms around them, Lord, they're dying, Father. We ask, Father, that you touch in our schools, Father. We've taken prayer out of our schools, Lord, but we don't take prayer from our youth. We teach our youth out of y'all on the name of Jesus. So right now, as we touch and agree, Father, we ask, Lord, that you protect them right now in the name of Jesus. Oh, cover them with the blood of Jesus, Father. Father, right now, some of us aren't feeling the greatest, Father, but we ask, Lord, that you touch us right now, Father. Oh, one touch from you, Father, and we'll run through hoops, Father. Oh, Father, we thank you right now for all that you've done for us. Thank you, Lord, for the things that even we couldn't see that you blocked, Lord. Thank you, Lord, right now for your protection. Father, we ask, Lord, that you forgive us all of our sins. Help us, Lord, to lean more on you, Father, to trust in your word, Father. Father, it is all these blessings we ask in the mighty name of Jesus. And every heart say amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, yes, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. What's his name?
feed me till I'm broke no more.
Came around and said, one day, one day.
read. In verse number 1, Psalms 23, and verse number 1.
Uh-huh. Come on.
That's enough.
All right.
What is that? The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. You may be seated.
Hallelujah.
Here, David was the one who wrote this. David would be given credit for writing these statements. Now, there's so much in this first verse that I really don't have time really to complete the verse today. But I will share just a portion, not all of it, just a portion of it, enough for you to go home and look at it again. Is that all right? Notice now, the verse begins by saying, the Lord. You put a period right there. The Lord. Now, it did not just say law, it said the Lord. See, during this particular time, my brothers and sisters, this particular passage, during the nighttime of David, yes, they had gods and laws for every day of the week. Everybody had a god. Everybody had a law. But thank God there's only one. And you got a lot of folk running right here talking about, there's only one. Yeah. They had an idol god. They had God Diana. They had wood god. I call my red wood. But they had wood god. Can I get a witness in here? And thank God for Jesus Christ. Yeah. They had a God Diana. They had wood god. They had God for every day of the week. 365 God. And if you look in your Bible, the word Lord is capitalized. It is not written in little bitty small letters. It is capital letters. And anytime you find capital letters in the Bible, the word Lord here means Jehovah. Jehovah God. The Lord Jehovah. He was and still is Jehovah. And always will be Jehovah. And the name Jehovah was such a secret name unto the Jews, yes, they would not allow his name to fall from their lips. Yeah, this name was only mentioned once a year. Can you imagine that? Only once a year? I don't know about you, but I call him all the time.
Amen.
Can I get a witness in here? It was when the priest would go behind the secret curtain, which was called the holiness of holies. And they would go once a year and bow down at the mercy seat. Yes, just to worship out the name Jehovah. Because it was such a secret name, a sacred name. And when the Jewish scribe would write out and ribbon in the Bible, and when they made it to the name Jehovah, they would put the pen down and start writing all over again. Just to write the name Jehovah. Because Jehovah's name was such a sacred name. Now, what David was saying when he said, the Lord is my shepherd. Yeah, he was talking about the great I am. And God knows he is the great I am. The greatest name I know is Jesus Christ.
Muhammad Ali was my friend. I loved him.
But Muhammad Ali was Jesus.
My daddy. They named me after my dad. I love my dad.
Yes, sir.
But daddy wasn't Jesus.
All right.
Yeah, he did make a way for me, Lord. Help me, Holy Ghost. Listen, thank God for Jesus Christ. For David said, he so was God until I asked myself in Psalms 139, verse 7 through 9, where can I flee from his spirit? Where can I go from his presence? If I make my bed in hell, he is there. If I take the wings of a dove and fly to the uttermost parts of the world, when I get there, he's already there. And I stopped right here to tell you this morning, whether you believe that he's right here. Right now. David said, the Lord is. And he put a period right there. Is. Good God Almighty. And that's what I love about God. For God is. He is God. Just by himself. You know, most of the people that we think about, they are wolves. Did y'all hear me? They are wolves. Muhammad Ali was. Yeah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I was pastor of the New Friendship Baptist Church. Help me, Holy Ghost. Lord, punish me right now. Thank you, Holy Ghost. That's what I love about God. He is God. Again, you know, most of the people, they think of themselves. They're not God. Only Jesus is God. Every people who used to box, they are used to be. And whether you believe it or not, I'm used to pass. We got a whole lot of used to be in here right now. They are in the used to be family. And what I love about the Lord, he is. He is right now God. And I trust you that he's right now God. 1,000 years ago, David had made this statement. David said, the Lord is. And here I am today saying, the Lord is. And my great, great, great grandchildren will be able to say, the Lord is. The Lord is. Not was, but is. And I guess if I had time, I could sit right there all night long saying, the Lord is. Can I get a witness there? Because, my brothers and sisters, you really know that God is a shepherd. You know you're not supposed to do that. I ain't supposed to do that, but I'm doing it. But in my conversation, if I would make a complete sentence about anything about the Lord, I could have put a period right on the other side of is. What you mean, Reverend Harvey? Well, if you're hungry, the Lord is food in the starving land. If you ain't got nowhere to stay, the Lord
is
a shepherd. Yeah. If you ain't got no friends, the Lord
is
a friend that can sit closer than a brother. Do I have a witness here? If you don't know your way, the Lord
is
a way out of no way. David said, the Lord
is
my shepherd. Finally, my brothers and sisters, we make it to the word mine. The Lord is
mine.
Personal David makes the Lord. Just reading this verse on the surface, you think the Lord is a little bitty God. But David said, I don't care how big he is, he is my shepherd. mine. Yeah, you know what you say. And when you say mine, you pray it close to home. And here David says something that only you as an individual can say. Yeah, David said, the Lord is my shepherd. I can stay right there all day. Jesus says, when you pray, say, our Father. Yes, when you say, our Father. Because all of us are in the household of faith. And those of us who are saved. And don't fool yourself, everybody in the church. Amen.
Amen.
You got some folk come in here.
Smoking cigars.
one lighten the other.
Come on now.
Just smoke it and smoke it.
Uh-huh.
One time, the Spirit spoke to me.
Yeah.
Put it down. Put it down.
Yeah.
I put it down and picked up Seek Himself.
The Lord is a guide.